Now give me feet pics. You want to see my feet? Here you go.
Why going on? You got anything?
Yeah.
Here you go, Jip. Yeah. You got a bottom of my feet. You like that?
What the hell?
What the fuck?
What the fuck?
Yo, did you just hit your PC, bro?
What'd you do, bro?
Alright. The first thing I wanted to talk about was Bleeding Edge. I did a first impressions on this like maybe like a month and a half ago when there was a beta for this game. And I said what they needed to do to improve it. And since then, the full game has released. So I thought I'd drop my review on it. I just letting y'all know, I really don't want to spend too much time talking about this game because unfortunately, my worst fears for this game happened. So for those of you unaware, first of all, Bleeding Edge is a third-person MOBA-esque team-based objective game from Ninja Theory. If you're unfamiliar with Ninja Theory, they recently just put out what many consider a classic in Hellblade, which was the game about mental health and shit. What else did Ninja Theory make? They made the Devil May Cry that nobody likes. Although I like that game, the one with the black hair, Heavenly Sword, Enslaved, Odyssey to the West, classic. Ninja Theory, in my opinion, they're a good studio. They have more hits than misses, in my opinion. But they made this game, third-person MOBA-esque action game, objective-based, where basically two teams of four go against each other with heroes, kind of like an Overwatch type thing. Each hero has different abilities and stuff like that. So you kind of got an idea idea where I'm kind of going with that. So I wrote down four positives for this, and I got more negatives since the full game came out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 negatives for this game. So if you're trying to figure out where we're going, you could probably figure out where we're going by the fact that there's 8 negatives. All right, so first positive for this game. Character design is cool. I think I said this in my beta impression, but so I don't want to sit here and repeat myself too much. All the characters have very interesting designs, very vibrant colors, very animated, very cool and anime inspired. So I do like the fact that they put a lot of love and care into the characters that make them stand out. The type of characters that I could see people cosplaying at like conventions and stuff like that. So I always like to give kudos to cool character design. But you know, at the end of the day, it's all about the gameplay. Next positive, every character felt useful to the point where, like, in my opinion, that's kind of like what I do like about this game. Every character felt useful, so it all comes down to preference and what you like. Don't get me wrong, like, you definitely need like a team healer or a team tank or whatever, but like which one you pick is up to you in terms of like the meta or whatever. So I do appreciate that it did feel, I would give a certain edge to certain characters, but like nothing felt like too OP or nothing felt completely useless. It mostly felt like just like preference. So I do like the fact that every character felt useful in this game. So in my opinion, it encourages experimentation when you do want to play the game. You do want to try out all the different characters in the roster. And all because every character feels useful, going to my third positive, I believe that teamwork is fun in this game. This game can be incredibly frustrating when you don't have anybody to play with, but when you do have people to play with and you all four of you are in sync and you're combining your abilities together to create combos, it's fun to watch all the vibrant colors explode. It's fun to watch your enemy just be decimated. It's just fun to decimate your family tree. If you played any type of MOBA type game, it's just fun to play with friends, come together, combine abilities, and do great things. And then also, I don't think I said this during the beta, but one thing that I do like about this game is the elevation. It kind of reminds me of Paragon. All the maps are not flat. None of the maps are flat. There's like staircases that you can jump off of, like different like hills and stuff like that, and like high level areas. So like if you're playing a gun character, having the high ground, the Australian chick with the helmet, having the high ground on like Anakin is important because you can shoot down on the enemies and you'll have like an advantage over them, or you can flank from above doing like a drop down. So like I always appreciate like a third person mobile with elevation. It reminds me a lot of Paragon. So those are the four positives that I have for the game. Like, it's, don't get me wrong, at the core, this is a fun objective based game, but I'm gonna get into the negatives and I'm gonna get into why I wouldn't recommend, because newsflash, I wouldn't recommend this game. So negatives: you cannot play this game with randoms. This is a super team based game. This game will either be really fun or it can be a complete headache. It's one of those games where like you have to be so coordinated. If you play with randoms, they're gonna drive you crazy, and that's not the game's fault. It's the community being dumb as hell, and then because it is team-based, but at the end of the day, it is still fucking annoying, and it's something to be aware of if you're interested in this game. The next negative, there's only 3 maps in this game. Maybe there's more. I flipped the rocks. I looked. We played this shit for like a good 2 weeks, nonstop. Fucking, I was looking. I was flipping. Maybe I didn't see them. But from what I've seen, there's only 3 maps in the retail version of this game. And I said in my first impressions of the beta, I said one of the things I want to see is more maps, because in the beta, there's only 2 maps. In the full game, there's 3. And I'm gonna be honest, I didn't even really like the third map like that. It was okay, but it wasn't as good as the 2 maps from the beta or whatever. So I'm like, wow, I don't give a fuck if this game is only $35. It's only 3 maps? I don't know. There's only 2 game modes. You know what's less than the maps? There's only 2 game modes. That's another thing I said in my beta first impression. I gave the beta a pass because, like, this is a beta. You can't show them everything. There's only 2 maps. There's only 2 game modes. Well, in the retail full version of this game, there's still only 2 game modes. And after about a couple hours, that shit gets pretty fucking boring. The 2 game modes are pretty... They're not even anything special. There's domination, which there are 3 points that you can capture. You work together, you capture those points, and you score a certain amount of points, that team wins. And the other game mode is basically glorified capture the flag. It's like battery capture. There are a bunch of batteries sprinkled around the map. You pick up the batteries, and then you wait for the portal to open. Until the portal opens, you fight each other, and you can make each other drop batteries, and then you dunk the batteries in the portal when the portal opens. At the end of the round, whoever has the most batteries dunked, that's who wins. That's it. There's nothing else. I was hoping maybe there were at least 2 or 3 more game modes, but there's only 2 game modes in the full release of the game. That's a shame to see. Skins are lackluster. What keeps people interested in playing games like these is like the cosmetics, the different cosmetics that are in the game. They're skins, but like each character has like 1 or 2 skins, and they're not even good. They're just like color variations. Like, cool, we need cool skins. Like, I need a different type of ninja skin for the dude with the fucking samurai sword or whatever. Like, it was just like, oh, okay, this is a blue character. Well, now you have a pink character. And then it costs a lot of money, so then you have to spend a lot of time playing the game. Actually, that's the knife negative. That just got off the top of my head. You have to spend a lot of time playing the game to build up in-game currency to get the shitty skins that are available in the game. The skins suck. It takes too much time to unlock the skins. It just feels like there's nothing to work towards in this game. So that's actually 9 negatives. Let me write that down. Currency, 2. Okay. The perks, there's perks in this game. So they have a perk system. Perk 30s. No, we're not popping them. So there's a perk system in the game where it's kind of like Call of Duty. Before every match, you go into your garage and you can equip different perks on each character. Maybe a perk will give you more health. Maybe it'll give you slightly more damage. It has basic stuff like that, more health or more damage or a slight cooldown on a certain ability. But the perks weren't interesting. They were just very basic. There was nothing that really stood out. Like something like in Destiny, like one of my favorite, I haven't played Destiny in like a year, Destiny 2, but like back when I was playing, one of my favorite pistols, I forgot the name of it, but it was a hand cannon. And whenever you got a kill, it would reload your shield or whatever. Like just something interesting like that. Like I don't feel like the perks were very interesting at all. So it made me, I never played with my loadout. I made one loadout and I never changed it because nothing really stood out. There were certain perks that were just obviously better than other ones, and they were very basic in ideology. It didn't change the gameplay mechanics upside down. And my thing is, what's the point of putting perks in the game if you're not gonna, you know, enhance the gameplay? It's just kind of like there to say, oh, we got perks. There's no ranked play in the retail version of this game, so all there is casual play. So if you did want to take this game seriously, which I would imagine people would want to, you would want them to, because this is a team-based objective game. You can't, because there's no ranked play. This is what I found in the retail version of the game. There's a bug in the game, at least on the PC side. I don't know with the Xbox. What's cool about this game is it has cross play between the Xbox and the PC. So it wasn't too hard, at least when I was playing it, because I'm not going to lie, I dropped this game already. But when I was playing it, it wasn't too hard to find a game. But the thing is, like, if you wanted to play with friends, at least on PC, you had to have the Xbox Live app installed on your PC. And then you also had to have the Xbox game bar installed to invite your friends. And the thing is, like, it like the software didn't work half the damn time. Half the time I could not invite my friends, even though, and like if you go on the Microsoft store, that Xbox game, it's something to do some of the Xbox game bar, Like, if you look on the reviews, this thing has like 2 out of 5 stars. And for a reason, it's buggy as hell. You can't invite your friends. And it's annoying as hell that I'm running 3 pieces of software at once. The game, the Xbox Live software, as well as the Xbox Game Bar. And I still couldn't invite people into the fucking match. What's the point of the Xbox Live if I can't invite people? I don't know if that's like it for like the Steam version, but for the Microsoft Store version, it was like that. I got this game for free, by the way. And that's the version they gave me. So I had to play the Microsoft Store. It has more to do with the Microsoft Store. That shit fucking sucks. It makes it hard to play with your friends and invite them. So the game is buggy. If you're playing it on PC, it can be hard to invite people. And then last but not least on my negatives, I put that I felt like this game was dead on arrival. Like the first week, it wasn't hard to find a game. Then like the second week, it took like a little bit longer. Then it's like, eh. Like, they didn't really promote this game. There's nothing really unique about it. There's no ranked play. I feel like the game, if we're being totally honest, at the core, I kind of look at this like Anthem. At the core, it is a fun game, but it's very undercooked. It needed more time in the oven, and they didn't promote it. So I feel like, I feel like it's very irresponsible for me to recommend this to my audience and tell them, yeah, go ahead and buy it, knowing the community is going to be dead within a month, you know? I feel like this game is dead on arrival. There's no promotion. There's no content. There's nothing to work towards. And there's only 2 game modes in 3 maps. Just feels like something. And it's funny, too, because people say Xbox don't got no games. Y'all not helping y'all case. Y'all not helping y'all case. So am I saying that this game is absolute dog shit? No. At its core, it is a fun game. Just everything else around it are all half-baked ideas. They're lazy. And it's like, honestly, I'd rather them hold this game and make this like whatever the Xbox Series X. I would have rather them make this like a launch title for that. Like, spend more time developing this game, because there's no way I can justify, even if it's $35, there's no way I can justify. The only way I can justify you playing this game is if you got the Xbox Game Pass for like $1 or whatever. Then sure, go ahead and try it out. But buying this game, nah, I can't recommend it. It's not, fuck this game, just skip it. Just skip, it doesn't exist. I'm gonna be honest, most of y'all probably didn't even know this game existed until I brought it up in this damn podcast. just skip it. You see, I stopped streaming that shit real quick. Microsoft don't care about the game, I don't care about it either. How about that? So those are my thoughts on Bleeding Edge. Hopefully you guys found that review helpful. If you did, please hit the like button on the video version of the podcast, or the video version of this review, because there will be a video version at some point whenever I get the time right and I edit it. But that's all I got to say about that.